This is our next problem, angular momentum of the conical pendulum. You have already studied conical pendulum in the unit 1 in Newton's laws of motion. So this is a figure of a conical pendulum. We can say there are two rods, okay, for this conical pendulum. So one rod is suspended here, okay, and there is a fulcrum here B, and let us consider this as the set axis, this vertical axis as the set axis. So from the fulcrum you have another rod of length L, okay, and when you rotate this first rod, okay, then this second rod also starts swinging. So there is a bob at the end of the second rod. Okay, this is the second rod. There is a bob at the end of the second rod of mass m. So when this first rod is rotated about the vertical axis, z axis, then the second rod, starting with the fulcrum B, the second rod will be started swinging, and this bob will be tracing a circular path in the xy plane, in the horizontal plane. This is a conical pendulum. Let us say during this circular, this is a rotation. During the rotation, we have taken one instant of the rotation, and let us say the angle that the conical pendulum makes with the vertical axis, z axis, alpha, and of course the length of this rod which is swinging is L. The mass of the bob is m. So we want to calculate the angular momentum of this bob about two reference points. One is A, point A, which is the center of the circular path traced by the bob in the xy plane. And the second is the angular momentum of the bob about this reference point, about point B, which is the fulcrum of the second rod. Okay. So first let us calculate the angular momentum about point A. Okay, so angular momentum about point A is equal to, we can write RA cross P. So what are these momentum vectors and RA vector? See, since let us say the bob is tracing the circular path along, okay, we can see that if the swing is like this, bob will be tracing the circular path in the anti-clockwise sense when we look from above. So the linear momentum at this point will be tangential to the circular path. This is the direction of linear momentum. And what is RA? The position vector from the point A. This is RA. Okay, this is RA. Now this RA is nothing but the radius of the circular path, magnitude of RA you can say, is equal to radius of the circular path. Okay. Therefore also, what is the direction of this LA? This is the direction in which RA proceeds. So when you rotate from the first vector RA to the second vector, the rotation is in the anti-clockwise sense, so that the angular momentum will be along the z direction. So this is the direction. This is the direction of LA along the z direction. Okay. Okay. So what is the magnitude of LA? Direction is along the plus z direction. What is the magnitude of LA? Okay, we can say, you can see that this RA is along the radius of the circular path. RA is actually equal to the radius of the circular path, and linear momentum is tangential to the circular path. So we can see that this R and P are mutually perpendicular. Okay, so the magnitude is simply magnitude of this cross product will be simply magnitude of RA into magnitude of P into sine theta, but that theta is 90 degree. So what is magnitude of RA? Simply R. What is the magnitude of P? It is M into V. Okay. So this is magnitude is MVR. But the linear velocity along tangential to the circular path is, we can write as R omega, where omega is the angular velocity of this conical pendulum. Okay. So linear velocity we can write as linear velocity along a circular path, we can write as radius times angular momentum. Okay. Okay, we will come back to this relationship. How this comes, we can see later. So we will quote this result. V is equal to R omega. So the magnitude of LA, we can write as M R square omega. Okay, instead of V, we have R omega, but R into R will be R square. So M R square omega. So then what is the vector formula for LA? M R square omega along plus K direction. This is LA. Okay, let's look at LB now. What is LB? LB is, we can write as RB cross P. What is RB? This is the point, reference point B. Okay. So RB is the position vector from the point B to the particle M. Okay. In other words, RB is nothing but this vector. This vector is RB. Okay. Let us look at the magnitude. So what is the magnitude of LB? It is simply magnitude of RB into magnitude of P. Here also we can see that the angle between RB and P will be perpendicular to each other. So the again theta is 90. Okay. The reason is that this circle is in the xy plane. Okay. And P is tangential to the circle. Okay. So this RB will be perpendicular to the linear momentum P. Okay, so the angle 90 will go. So we can simply write this as what is the magnitude of RB? Magnitude of RB is length of the conical pendulum, and P is nothing but M into V, which we can also write as M R omega. Okay, so magnitude is M R omega L. This is magnitude of LB. What is the direction of LB? Direction of LB you have to find out in each case. Direction of LB will be perpendicular to both RB. It's RB cross P, right? So it's perpendicular to both RB and P, right? So this will not be constant, because as the pendulum, as the bob traces a circle in the xy plane, P will be different. The direction of P, even the magnitude of P remains same, direction of P will be tangential to this circle, so it will vary from point to point. And also the direction of RB also will vary from point to point. It means that the direction of LB will be different at different points. Look at the magnitude of LB, it will be the same. M is a constant, R is a constant, omega is a constant, and L is a constant. So the magnitude of LB will be a constant, but its direction will not be a constant. On the other hand, when you look at LA, okay, magnitude of LA is a constant, MR square omega is a constant. This conical pendulum is undergoing uniform, is rotating with the uniform angular velocity omega. So magnitude of LA is a constant, and direction of LA is also constant. It's always along the plus Z direction. This is the direction of LA. Whereas direction of LB, magnitude of LB, though it's a constant, direction of LB will not be constant. Okay. In order to illustrate that, let us consider two points along this circular path. So let us redraw this diagram. Okay. This is the initial road. This is the fulcrum B. And this is the vertical. Let us say this represents the circular path of the bow. Okay, let us consider two diametrically opposite points, one here. Okay, this is our conical pendulum. So this is the direction of RB, and direction of P will be tangential. So tangential to the circular path, P will be like this. Okay, so when you take this is RB direction. When you take RB cross P, okay, the direction of LB will be like this. Perpendicular to both RB and P. You can check that using right hand grip rule. Let us consider another point, diametrically opposite point here. Okay. And, this time this is RB. Let me extend this. This is the direction of RB. And this time this is moving in the anti-clockwise sense. Okay. So this time the direction of P will be like this. This is the direction of P because it is revolving in the anti-clockwise sense. So if you rotate, if you use the right hand grip rule and rotate the fingers from RB cross P, the direction of LB will be perpendicular to both RB and P like this. This is the direction of LB. Okay. So you can see that the direction of LB varies as this conical pendulum traces the circular path in the horizontal plane. In fact, if you look at the entire path of this pendulum, okay, we can see that as the pendulum traces a circular path in the XY plane, the direction of LB will trace a cone like this. Okay, LB will be tracing different directions, and all these directions will lie along a cone. So this this cone represents all the directions of LB. So this is the conclusion. Here also we have seen that if you calculate the angular momentum of the bob of the conical pendulum about two reference points, about the reference point A, which is the center of the circular path, what you get is m r square omega k. Magnitude and direction are constant. Direction is along plus that direction. And if you consider another reference point, this fulcrum B, magnitude is constant, even though it's different from LA, its magnitude is constant, but direction is not constant. Direction traces, the direction vectors lie along a cone as the pendulum revolves in the bob revolves in the, traces a circular path in the XY plane. The direction vectors of LB traces a cone, okay, about the z-axis. Okay, so these are the two examples, preliminary examples that we have discussed. In both cases, what we have to, the take-home message is that the magnitude as well as direction of angular momentum of a body depends on the choice of the, depends on two factors. One, it's a motion, what is the linear momentum of the body. And secondly, it depends upon the choice of the reference point about which we are calculating the angular momentum. That's all.